Yes, I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh Lord, some of these days I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother howdy when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother hey when I shake mother hand that day. That's when I want, oh, that milky white way, some of these days. I want to meet God the Father and God the Son. Yes, I want to meet God the Father.
Our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, we have a building of God, and house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. For in this we groan earnestly, desiring to be clothed upon with our house, which is from heaven. And if so be that being clothed, we shall not be found naked. For we that are in this tabernacle do groan, being burdened, not for that we would be unclothed, but clothed upon that mortality might be swallowed up of life. Now he that has wrought us for the selfsame thing is God, who also have given unto us the earnest of the Spirit. Therefore, we are always confident, knowing that while we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord, for we walk by faith and not by sight. We are confident, I say, and willing, rather, to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. For I know that this shall turn to my salvation through our prayer and the supply of the Spirit of Jesus Christ, according to my earnest expectation and my hope, that in nothing I shall be ashamed, but that with all boldness, as always, so now also, Christ shall be magnified in my body, whether it be by life or by the flesh. This is the fruit of my labor. Yet shall what I shall choose I want not, for I am in a strait betwixt two, having a desire to depart and to be with Christ, which is far better. For I know that my Redeemer liveth, that he shall stand at the later day upon the earth. Though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God. There is a time for everything, and a season for every activity under heaven. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to uproot. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to tear down, and a time to build. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones, and a time to gather them. A time to embrace, and a time to refrain. A time to search, and a time to give up. A time to keep, and a time to throw away. A time to tear, and a time to mend. A time to be silent, and a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time of war, and a time of peace. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He guideth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou prepare a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointed my head with oil, my cup overflowed. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many mansions. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I'm going? Thomas said unto him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? And Jesus said unto him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one cometh unto the Father except by me. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Then Jesus said, be happy with those who are happy, and weep with those who weep. For, O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? For sin is the sting that results in death. And the law gives sin its power. But thank God, he gives us victory over sin and death through our Lord Jesus the Christ. Paul said, for I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day. And not to me only, but unto all of them also that love his appearing. For which cause we faint not, but though our outward man perish, yet the inward man is renewed day by day. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. While we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. But the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. Amen. Amen. Good afternoon. This is the day that the Lord has made.
Yes, Lord.
And even on this occasion, we must rejoice and be glad in the day that the Lord has made.
Yes.
Now, don't get me wrong. I know that one of our dear loved ones have gone on to be with the Lord, so there will be some sadness. But I'll tell you that I'm glad that I have the Lord on my side. And somebody else ought to be able to tell him thank you for waking me up this morning, for starting me on my way. Somebody ought to be glad that they had a chance to meet this valiant soldier, Sister Doretha Grant, who the Lord blessed for over 92 years to be on this side of glory. We ought to be glad that we had a chance to fellowship and to tabernacle with her, such a wonderful woman, such a wonderful mother, such a wonderful grandmother, such a wonderful wife, such a wonderful friend. So we came to celebrate, my brothers and sisters, the homegoing of this God's own soldier. Now, if you knew Sister Doretha, you know she loves some singing. If you knew Sister Doretha, you knew she loved church. So we came to have some church today. We came to lift him up, because he's shining high. We lifted up that he would draw all men unto himself. It's a good day when one of the soldiers make it home. And so we're going to have a good time. The family has outlined the program, and we're going to govern ourselves accordingly. Everything should be decent and in order. And the program calls for the final viewing, which has been done, a musical selection, prayer of comfort, the Old Testament scripture by Reverend Corbin, New Testament scripture, Elder Clark, and then another musical selection. Amen. We're going to govern ourselves accordingly. Next, we'll hear from the choir, and I'll come up and do the prayer of comfort, and then the rest will follow behind me. Amen.
Yeah.
Father, because we realize that we can't do nothing without you. Or we can't sing right today without you. I certainly can't pray right today without you. without you. We can't live and we can't even die without you. And so we're calling on you. We look to the hills from which cometh our help, knowing that all of our help, when we're sick, all of our help, when we're confused, all of our help, when we're sad, all of our help, it comes from you. So today, Father God, we ask that you just wrap your loving arms around this great family. Build a shield of protection around them. And just help them through the next few hours, the next few days, the next few weeks, and the next few months. Lift them up as only you can. We can pray and we can do things on this side, but some things are bigger than I. And so we're calling on you to protect. We're calling on you for wisdom. We're calling on you for guidance. But we know, Father God, that you are a God that cannot make a mistake. Amazing sight. The Savior stands. And he knocks on every door. 10,000 blessings in his hand to satisfy the poor. We need you, Father. Hold us with that righteous hand. See us through these difficult days. And we'll be so careful, Father, to give you all the glory, to give you all the hallelujahs and amens that you need, for they belong to you. All the glory and all the honor. This is your humble servant's prayer. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In the holy and righteous name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen again.
Amen.
One more time.
Amen.
It is good for us, what, to be here.
Amen.
Our scripture reading comes from Psalms 34, verse 1 down to verse number 3. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Listen what the Bible says. He said, I will.
I will.
Do I have some help in here?
I will.
Bless the Lord.
Amen.
At all times.
Right.
I got to do it.
Uh-huh.
At all times.
Time.
Well, why you got to do it? Because his praises were shall continue to be in my mouth.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to praise God whatever position I'm in. I got to praise him. And today is a good time to praise him. And he said, oh, somebody said, oh. He said, oh, magnify. I said, oh, magnify. I said, oh, magnify. The Lord with me. And let us exalt his name. We're going to exalt his name what? Together. Can I get a witness? All they got to do is just bless the Lord at all times. And his praises shall continue this to be in my mind.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Get up to the Spirit of Christ this afternoon to the Reed family, to the honorary pastor of this church, Dr. Daniel and his wife, to the choir that's singing so lovely, to my lovely wife over in the corner. Praise the Lord. I don't think the hymn writer made a good statement when he says, you can't take things for granted. Sometimes we wonder, do we take things for granted? And we shouldn't take it for granted. Our sister, we're just like a vapor. We're here today and we're gone tomorrow. But for a reading for you today, come from the book of Ephesians. Praise the Lord. The fourth chapter. Starting with the fourth verse. There is one body and one spirit. Even as he are called and one hope are you called it. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in you all. May the Lord bless to hear and read of his great word.
next on the program, we have Reflections. As a neighbor, Mother Harmon, as a co-worker, Miss Patrick, and as a friend, Mrs. Butts. Amen. There's a microphone on the side over here.
Amen.
So desire. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. Everything that has rest on what?
Praise
the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
As a neighbor. Praise the Lord. When I moved in the neighborhood, the Doretha was already there and looked like we'd been there forever. Lord, have mercy. Today upon the family, Lord, the family and I seem like them, just like them people. Me and Ellie, Cal, we worked together at the hospital some years. And we were just like them, neighbors, never had no, nothing. Just love one another. And I want y'all to know I love y'all. Quint, you got to come see me. I ain't seen you in a minute. And I thank the Lord for being somebody said it's a blessing just to be here.
Yes.
Praise the Lord, it is a blessing to be alive, y'all. Praise the Lord. And I thank the Lord. You know He let us live a long time.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. And I thank the Lord for that.
At 2:30, because I couldn't be late, do I be left going to work? She knows one time.
All right.
And I know on Saturday, it would be a little early because we had to go by Carterburg to get some potato yams. That's how I learned to eat potato yams from Carterburg. So I know when Saturday comes, she was picking me up. It had to be 15 minutes early because we was going to be to work on time. That's one thing. I was to work on time, but when I worked long enough and got me a car, I went always on time. But anyway, Doretha and I worked together about 15 years at Crane Retirement. Today is, I think it's Chris Regent Health and Rehab now. But I'm telling you, it was never a dull moment with Doretha. Not only did the employees respected her, the patients. I know we went side by side, not only in that facility, but we were side by side. And some days when Doretha was off, and I call her Doretha, y'all, I respected her, but I said dope. That's what I said, dope. But some days when she was off and the patient needed something done, you couldn't do it. It wasn't getting done until Doretha get. I'll wait till Doretha come back. That's just how much they loved her. But anyway, down through the years, like Pastor say, singing, and this was like, I think the late, in like 1976 or something. We was gospel singing partners. We would travel together to sing it. And sometime we would run into where one of us had to work. And Doretha say, oh, girl, you go on, I work. I said, oh, thank you, I don't want to go to the singing that she did too. But that's just the type of person she was. And to the family, she was more like a mother figure to me, because she would tell me when I was wrong, and she would tell me when I was right. I don't think, we never got mad with each other, you know, because she was just gonna tell you just like it was. But a song came to my mind, it's an old song by the Soul Stirrer, and she loved this song. And the song say, one of these days I'm going home to get my just reward. And I'll be resting in Eden, over on the other shore. So to the family today, Sister Doretha is resting in Eden, over on the other shore.
We got married, kind of like we did. We got come to church together. We worked together at a hotel, Howard Duncan Hotel. We worked together there. We always be friends. And like two pastors say, down in our lives, we got hope. You know, we would go to church together, things that we could love. That was her life. And like Sister Trent said, she was her chauffeur, but I was Doretha's chauffeur. Oh, why? Low, she'll be coming low. She said, she let me know what was on. She kept me day. She said, let's go. I never took time to Doretha die. Always love, bless me, always have transportation. Doretha, transportation now. But she was driving. So that's our life. But we had a wonderful relationship. Because when you just meet a girl, two young girls, they were teenagers, they say, all these young blessings, mm-hmm. always come back to together. Yeah. Whatever was in our lives, we always would overcome and come back together.
Amen.
I call her as my daughter. That's how much I do. So she come on as my daughter. So y'all just became a part of my thing.
That's not
we
right.
Share a grandson together. That is how other lives became. And I always remember my family lover and I love her. But I said to no reason. Baby, I love you. Be fine and take your breath. God love you.
Yes.
God, I love you, but God love
you. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
I came to tell you
what Jesus did.
Thank you.
shall work with the waiting congregation. We ask, Father God, that you be with us, you lead us, and guide us as only you can. We ask that you bring peace into this house. Bring joy into this house. Bring love into this house. And help us to understand what the Spirit is saying unto the church. Hide me behind the cross so that men, women, boys, and girls would not see me but see the true and living God. And we'll be so careful to give you all the honor and all the glory. In Jesus' matchless name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Our scripture text is coming today from Revelation chapter 14 and verse 13. And it reads, "And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, Write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord from henceforth. Yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works do follow them." Amen. So just for a short time, I want to talk to you from the subject, the blessings in death. My brothers and sisters, oftentimes when we think about death, we get scared and we think about something in a fearful way. You heard the worldly version of death, they talk about the grim reaper showing up. And the man with the chilly hand of death, he shows up, the mysterious angel of death. And he have all of us terrified, thinking that death is a lonely way. It's a way that God almost has forsaken us, but we know that that's just the world. Because the Bible tells us in Ecclesiastes chapter 7 and verse 1 that a good name is better than precious ointment. And the day of our death is better than the day of our birth. And so God has given us, and he gave Doretha 90 plus years from the date of her birth up until now to get it right with him. And she, during those times, had the time to get a good name, a wonderful name, a person that was just as sweet and honorable as you ever wanted to meet. And so the end days were bittersweet because we'll no longer see her again, but there's a blessing in the death. Many things and all the things on this side must come to an end. And when people think about things coming to an end, they oftentimes be sad about it. But many times it's a blessing and even the thing coming to an end. Because as we get older, stuff just doesn't work the way it used to work. Sometimes when you get out of bed, it seems like you're stuck, Brother Parker, in second gear. You can't downshift and you can't upshift. You ain't got one speed. And that's a slow speed and it still gets you tired. And so coming to the end of all that, it ain't bad news, y'all, because it's the end of the cares of this world. It's the end of not having to worry about your memory. And sometimes, I don't know about you, but I I go in the room and forget what I went in the room for. And stand there a while. I know I ain't by myself. And look around for a while. Cause oh yeah, I came for the bag of tater chips. I got them. Let me go back in and watch some TV. Take a while sometimes. But one of these old days, y'all, we ain't gonna have to worry about that no more. It's gonna be the end of all of our suffering. It's gonna be the end of worrying about things. Sister Doretha don't have to worry no more. She don't have to worry about what's gonna happen during the day. She don't have to worry about her children anymore. And the grandchildren. She's gone on to a better place. The end of that thing is really just a blessing. Because sometimes when you stayed here a long time, and I know my elders can attest to it, all of your friends done gone and left. And I know she missed Mr. Curtis. I missed him myself. Sitting right back there in the corner, both of them. Amen. And I remember one time they got up, it was doing birthdays, we were honoring birthdays and anniversaries. And they stood up for anniversary. And I said, Mr. Curtis, how long has it been? And I thought about it after I asked him. I said, it's been long. He might have been a forgot. I said, Mr. Curtis, don't you worry about it. Because you mess around and miss that date, Miss Doretha might shoot your elbow. But they got it together. I think they was on one accord, and they came up with the right answer. I said, Mr. Curtis, don't you get in trouble, man. And he got it out there. But you know, it's just a blessing, and today is a beautiful day, even though it may be raining on the outside. It's joy on the inside because one of our souls. You know, for a pastor, this is a good day. You don't have to worry when you preach a sermon about one of the children. It's a good day. And so I'm happy today that she don't have to worry anymore. And so some people say, it's the ending, but really, let me tell you, it's just the beginning. It's the time now, Mary, that she can take her rest. It's the beginning of her rest that she can rest from her labor. And she can sit down and be in the presence of the Lord. Now, I know she loved all of us. But if she had a chance to come back, once she get a taste of being with the Lord, once she get over there and see Mr. Curtis waiting on over there, ain't no way, Mary, that she coming back this way. It's just the beginning of her comfort with the Lord. It's just the fruits of her labor now that she will be able to enjoy. She's going to enjoy life, and that life that they talked about more abundantly, this is what she's going to be enjoying. She ain't got to worry about no sickness no more. She ain't got to worry about no heart trouble no more. She ain't even got to cry no more, and if she did, God's going to wipe away all of her tears. And so this is not the end, and it is just the beginning. And so I say, as I get ready to close, my brothers and sisters, that we got to be happy when the saints are able to go home. And as I get ready to close, I'm reminded of a story. There was a young man. The young man had went off to college, and while he was in college, he got married and had a family. He worked odd jobs and did all he had to do to take care of his family. And when he graduated college, He thought that everybody was going to take care and that everything was going to be all right. But with that college degree, he got a lot of heartaches. Y'all know how some folks would do you when you went to one job. They say you got a college degree, they said you're overqualified. Yeah, and then he went to another place. They said that's all you got, you are underqualified. And the young man got frustrated and didn't know what to do. Everywhere he went, the doors was closed in his face. And after a while, he began to apply all over the world. Then companies from out of state, New York, and in the city began to call. And he went to his wife, he said, "Hey, honey, I'm gonna have to leave for a while." He had to sell his house and everything that he had. And then his wife had to go live with a mother and the children too. He went and he hugged his wife and his children and said, "One of these old days, we're gonna see each other again. But I must take this journey and go and take care of my family. You may not see me for a while, but one of these old days, we will be together again." So he went up north and he got him a good job. He began to make some good money. He began to move on up in the company. After a while, he was able to get him a nice house. Yeah, with a backyard and a fence. Yeah, it wasn't long before he called his wife and said, "Baby, I need you to come on up. I got everything just right for you. And I want to tell you, when they got together, when all of God's children get together, can't you imagine? The husband done been away from the wife. The husband done been away from the children. When they got together, they was able to come together and have a good time. It's just like Brother Grant and Sister Grant. He done gone on a little bit sooner. And he done prepared a place for all of us. I'm glad, so glad, that the God I serve, he done already put a mansion up there for me. I'm glad that one of these old days, I'm gonna be able to see my mother. Said he would. And I'm glad, so glad, that I don't have to worry even while I'm down here. Because my God takes care of me. And no matter what you go through, our God, our God, is it on time? He's watching us. Taking care of us, no matter what we go through. So I'm going to leave you with this as we continue on this journey to the grand family. We're going to make it. Hills might get high. The valleys might get low. But we're going to make it. I'm so glad that he gives us everything that we need. Amen. To gonna make it to where we need to be. Every step by.
Call it. Love me. Release me. Let me go. I have so many things to see and do. You mustn't tie yourself to me with tears. Be happy that we had so many years. I gave you my love, and you can only guess how much you gave me in happiness. I thank you for the love that you each have shown, but now it is time that I traveled alone. So grieve a while if grieve you must. Then let your grief be comforted by trust. It's only for a while that we must part. So bless the memories within your heart. I won't be far away, for life goes on, so if you need me, call and I will come. Though you can't see or touch me, I'll be near. And if you listen with your heart, you'll hear my love around you so soft and so clear. And then when you too must travel this way alone, I'll greet you with a smile and say welcome home. The family of Mother Doretha Grant is most appreciative for the many kind and loving expressions of sympathy that you each have shown. They ask for your continued prayers in the days to come, and may each of you continue the blessings of the Lord. The following floor arrangements have been sent to the family. Hoping each loving memory will soften the grief you feel now, bring peace and healing day by day. Kalisha, Lula, Carl, Isha, Erica, the McKenzie family, we love you and we're going to miss you. May you find peace in the days to come and the loving thoughts that are with you now. Miss Nettie Bush and family, Karen Dawson and family, Angela Jackson and family, hoping each loving memory will soften the grief you feel now. Mr. Victory and Rosalind Montford. With deepest sympathy, the Corbin and Colson family. With deepest sympathy, the Thomas family. With deepest sympathy, you are in our prayers, Elois Butts and the Butts sisters. With deepest sympathy, Mary Henderson and family. With deepest sympathy, Tracy, Kim, Kai, Kyrie, your loving grandkids. Rest well, Mama Doretha, the Screaming Eagles Motorcycle Club, Cordele, Georgia. With deepest sympathy from Theron Jones and family. Tanisha and family, with deepest sympathy, April and family. With heartfelt sympathy to you and your family as we remember a life so very well lived. The Bridges family of Atlanta and New Jersey. With deepest sympathy, Deacon Bobby James and family. We will miss you from Crossroad Missionary Baptist Church, Pastor Maynard. With deepest sympathy, Mr. Victory and Rosalind Montford. The family flower is giving loving memory of a loving and caring mother, grandmother, sister, aunt, and friend from the family, and loving memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, CEO and President, along with staff of J.W. Williams Funeral Home, is pleased to present to this family an African-American family heirloom Bible in the hope that it will serve as a source of added comfort and peace in the days to come. We are also pleased to present to this family a pictorial tribute of your loved one's life. It is our prayer that you will forever remember the many cherished memories you've shared as a family. And finally, present this memorial blanket. It is our prayer that you wrap yourself in the love and warmth that this blanket holds and may be a constant reminder of your beloved. For anyone that has ever loved is never lost. It is our prayer that you're blessed now and always.
Amen. Amen.